Hello, my dear student. I hope you all are at your home healthy and happy. So, be ready for study. Today, we will learn about placental abnormality. Before that, we just go through what is placenta. Placenta is an discoid shaped organ that is attached to the upper segment of the uterus. It is an important part to provide nourishment to the fetus through the umbilical cord. Placenta is explored after the delivery of the fetus. So, first we will discuss about the placental abnormality. First abnormality is an placental succinturiata. What is placental succinturiata? Is an one or more small lobe of the placenta, size of cotyledon, may be placed at the varying distance from the placental margin. Normally in the placenta there is a 15 to 20 cotyledon or 15 to 20 lobe are present on the placenta. In this type of condition, from that 15 to 20 cotyledon or placental lobe, the one of the lobe is distance placed at the margin of the placenta. In case of absence of communicating blood vessels, it called a placenta spuria. Between the varying lobe and the whole placenta, there is a communicable blood vessels is present. If there is no communicable blood vessels is present, it called a placenta spuria. Incidence is 3%. You can see in this image, there is one lobe is separated from the whole placenta and there is blood vessels is communicating between the placenta and the separated lobe. If there is no blood vessels is present, it called a placenta spuria. But if there is a communicating blood vessels is present, it called a placenta succinturiata. What all are the clinical manifestation or clinical significance of the placental succinturiata is an, if the succinturate lobe is retained following birth of the placenta, it may be lead to. Means if the succinturated lobe is retained in the uterus after the expulsion of the placenta or after the birth of the placenta, that can lead to the postpartum hemorrhage. Subinvolution. Subinvolution means the reproductive organ is not revert to the non-pregnant state. Uterine sepsis. Sometimes this retained succinturated lobe is lead to the infection of the uterus and polyp formation. Next is an treatment. What are the treatment of placenta succinturiata is, whenever the diagnosis of missing lobe is made, exploration of the uterus and removal of the lobe under the general anesthesia is to be done. Whenever the obstetrician or a midwife is known or diagnosed that is a one lobe or one succinturated lobe is missing in the uterus, it retained in the uterus, that time we have to explore the uterus and remove the retained lobe of the placenta under the general anesthesia. We can use the under general anesthesia and then after we can remove the lobe of the retained placenta. This is the first condition of the placental abnormality. It called a placental succinturiata. Means the one lobe is retained or succinturated from the whole placenta and placed at the margin of the placenta. Second condition is then placental extracorialis. What is placental extracorialis is divided into two types, circumvallate placenta and placental marginata. First we will discuss about circumvallate placenta. You can see this image. Okay, what is the circumvallate placenta? It is the subtype of the placenta extracorialis in which the membrane, chorion membrane or amnion membrane, is double back on the fetal side around the edge of the placenta. You can see in this image, in this type of the placenta, this is the subtype of the extracorialis, and in this type of the placenta, on the fetal membrane, on the fetal surface, there is two membranes is present. It called a chorionic membrane and amnionic membrane. In this type of condition, the chorion membrane and amnion membrane is rolled back over or double back over on the fetal side around the edge of the placenta. What all are the clinical significance? This is the increased chance of abortion, antepartum hemorrhage, FGR, preterm delivery, retained placenta or membrane. If there is a placenta, circumvallant placental condition is present that lead to abortion, antepartum hemorrhage, fetal growth retarded baby, preterm delivery and retained lobe of placenta or retained membrane of the placenta. Next is an placental marginata. This is also a subtype of the placental extracorialis. What is the meaning of placental marginata is a thin fibrous ring is present at the margin of the chorionic plate where the fetal vessels appear to terminate. In this type of condition, one of the fibrous ring is appear at the margin of the chorionic plate. There is a on the fetal membrane there is a chorionic plate and amniotic plate is present. On the chorionic plate there is an end of the fetal vessels is appear. At that site of the chorionic plate, one of the fibrous ring is present at the margin of the chorionic plate, that called a placenta marginata. Next is an placental membranacea. What is the placental membranacea? It is the rare placental abnormality characterized by the presence of fetal membrane covered by the chorionic villi. In this type of the placental abnormality, this is also in this type of the placental abnormality, the fetal membrane, complete fetal membrane or partial fetal membrane is covered by the chorionic villi and presence at the fetal part or fetal membrane. In this type of the placental abnormality, the membrane of placenta is covered with the chorionic villi and present at the fetal membrane. This is the rarest abnormality of the placenta. Clinical significance is enrochment of some part over the lower segment. Normally the placenta is attached at the upper segment of the uterus, but if there is a placental membranacea is present, some part of the placenta is enroached to the lower segment of the uterus. Imperfect separation in third stage. During the third stage of labor, there is a separation of placenta is occur. If there is a placenta membranacea is present, the separation is not occur properly. It is imperfect. Chances of retained placenta is more and manual removal become difficult. If there is a placenta membranacea is present, the chances of retained placenta is present means there is a some part or some lobe of placenta is retained in the uterus. For the retained part of the placenta, we can diagnose or we can treat through the manual removal of the placenta. But if there is a placenta membranacea is present, there is a difficulty occurred for the manual removal of the placenta. So this is rarest with the dangerous condition of the placental abnormality. Next is in placenta accreta, increta and percreta. These abnormalities are serious variation in which the trophoblastic tissue invade the myometrium to varying depth. In this type, this is then a rarest abnormality and with serious abnormality of the placenta. What is occur in this type of the abnormality? There is a trophoblastic tissue of placenta is attached to the myometrium of the uterus or invade in the myometrial layer of the uterus. There is a total three layer of the uterus: myometrium, endometrium and perimetrium. If there is a placenta accreta, increta or percreta is present, that time the tissue of trophoblastic of the placenta is invade or it develop or attach in the myometrium of the uterus. They are much more likely with placenta previa or with the implantation over a prior uterine incision or perforation. this condition is associated with the other abnormal condition. This is also associated with the placenta previa. What is placenta previa? Placenta previa is an abnormal condition in which the placenta partially or completely implanted over the lower segment of the uterus. If there is a placenta previa is present, that time the more chances for the placenta accreta, increta and percreta. Next, we will discuss about definition of accreta, increta and percreta. First, placenta accreta. What is placenta accreta? It occurs when the all or part of the placenta attach abnormally to the myometrium. In this condition, the part of the placenta or whole part of the placenta or some part of the placenta, it attach abnormally to the myometrial layer of the uterus. Second, placenta increta. What is placenta increta? It is condition where the placenta attach more firmly to the uterus. This condition is more serious than the placenta accreta. In this type of the condition, the placental layer or placenta is attached more firmly to the uterus, more deeply to the uterus. Next is an placenta percreta. In this condition, it is the condition in which the placenta attach itself and grow through the uterus and potentially to the nearby organ. This is an most abnormal condition of the among these three. In this condition, the placenta, whole placenta, it attach itself to the uterus, to the layer of the uterus and grow through the uterus. In this type of the condition, the placenta is go through the uterus and potentially to the nearby organ, means normally the bladder is a nearby organ of the placenta. If there is a placenta percreta is present, the placenta is on a potential nearby organ of the uterus. It is made a nearby organ of the uterus. Placenta accreta is condition usually associated with the following condition. First, when the placenta implanted in the lower segment, means placenta previa, or over the previously injured site as in caesarean section, or the mother has an caesarean section, or at the site of the caesarean section, dilatation and curettage operation. If the mother is go through the dilatation and curettage operation, there is a more chances of the placenta accreta. Manual removal. If there is a previous pregnancy or previous delivery, the manual removal procedure is occur, that time the placenta accreta is an chances, and myomectomy. Next is a diagnosis. Which are the diagnosis? During attempted manual removal, where the plane of the cleavage between the placenta and uterine wall cannot be made out. First diagnosis is a manual removal of the placenta. Second is an uterine imaging. Color Doppler and MRI have been valuable in the diagnosis. These are the rarest serious condition of the placental abnormality is in placenta accreta, increta and percreta. Today we was discussed about placental abnormality. First is in placenta succinturata. Placenta succinturata means the one succinturated lobe is attached to the distance of the placental margin. If there is a communicated blood vessels is present, it called a placenta succinturata. If there is a no any communicable blood vessels is present, it called a placenta spuria. Its treatment is the manual removal of the placenta and following the exploration of the uterus. Second condition is an placenta extracorialis. Placenta extracorialis is subdivided into circumvallate placenta and marginata placenta. In that, the circumvallate placenta means the membrane of the fetal is rolled back or doubled back on the fetal side. Placenta marginata means the fibrous ring is present at the margin of the chorionic plate. Third condition is the placental membranesia. What is placental membranesia? Means the complete or partial fetal membrane is covered by the chorionic villi and present at the fetal membrane. And lastly, there is a three condition, placenta accreta, increta and percreta. This is an serious and abnormal condition. In that, the placenta accreta means the placenta is abnormally attached to the myometrium. Increta means the placenta is firmly or deeply attached to the uterus. And in the placenta percreta, the placenta is itself attached to the uterus and grow through the uterus, and potentially it to be a part or to be a organ of the nearby organ of the placenta. Placenta percreta is the rarest and most dangerous condition of the placental abnormality. Be happy, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.